April 15th. It reads, "To me, the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to preach to the Gentiles the unfathomable riches of Christ, and to bring to light what is the administration of the mystery which for ages has been hidden in God who created all things, in order that the manifold wisdom of God might now be made known to the rulers and the authorities in the heavenly places. This was in accordance with the eternal purpose which he carried out in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have boldness and confidence, access through faith in him. Therefore I ask you not to lose heart at my tribulations on your behalf, for they are your glory." As soon as I saw these verses being the verses that I was given to create a lesson on, immediately I realized that this was going to be a fun challenge. It was going to be hard, but it was going to be enjoyable and would help me. As I studied these verses, I noticed a common theme, and this theme was that God had a plan for the church. It wasn't just, there are so many verses that are connected to this that have that same theme. Let's take a few minutes this morning to study on this topic just a little bit. Our first text will come from 2 Timothy 1:9. That's 2 Timothy 1:9. Reads, "Who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which he has granted us in Christ Jesus from all eternity." God had always had a plan. It's always been there. It's always had a plan forever and ever for his church. His own purpose and grace was granted to us in Christ from all eternity, since the beginning, from the start. It's always been there. If you'll turn with me to Ephesians 1, 4 through 5, we'll also find some similar. Again, that's Ephesians 1, 4 through 5. "Just as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him in love, he predestined us to adoption as sons through Jesus himself, to himself, according to the kind intention of his will." God chose us to be his people through Christ before the foundation of the world, from all of time. And again, that's a common theme that we will see in these texts. Our next text will be Ephesians 3:11. Another page. It's Ephesians 3:11. "This was in accordance with the eternal purpose which he carried out in Christ Jesus our Lord." Again, we see the eternal purpose. It's been there from the beginning. And we see that it was there before the world came. We saw that it was predestined to be, and that it's been there forever. If you'll turn with me to Romans 8:29. Romans 8:29 reads, "For whom he foreknew, he also predestined to become conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren." And when I looked at this, of course, I immediately noticed predestined, and that was what I called a common word. There are a few common words in all of these texts, and it was there. It was the plan before time. It was always the plan. We are predestined to that. And I also noticed that it says to be conformed to the image of his Son, to be like Jesus. And I thought about the what would Jesus do bands that people would wear. And it's always been, as Christians, we are to be like Jesus. We are to look at him as our model. And I thought that was interesting that, it was predestined. It was always to be that way. Through these texts, we can see the amazing wisdom of God on display for the plan that he have a plan for his church. God has kept his plan from the church hidden. There's a reason, though. So, if you'll turn with me to 1 Corinthians 2:8. It reads, "The wisdom which none of the rulers of this age has understood, for if they had understood it, they would have not have crucified the Lord of glory." Paul talks about how God knew that people would try to sabotage the plan had they known what the intention was. We through that, most likely would not have been saved through that way, at least. And this, I think this is, I mean, I say it's here, but this is the reason that God kept it hidden. If you'll turn with me to Ephesians 3:9. Bring to light what is the administration of the mystery which for ages has been hidden in God who created all things. It's been hidden. It's been hidden in God. It was not made known to anyone. This verse will, and as we saw, states that it was hidden and that for ages it had been planned. If you'll turn with me to 2 Timothy 1:9, we'll see some more. Who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was granted us in Christ Jesus from all eternity. Purpose and grace, which was granted to us through Christ. It also, in this verse, it states that it was to be from all eternity. It was hidden from all eternity. It was revealed by the death of Jesus. If you'll turn with me to 1 Corinthians 2:7. And it reads, "But we speak God's wisdom in a mystery, the hidden wisdom which God predestined before the ages to our glory." And again, we see this common theme of it being hidden. It's hidden in God. And there is predestined again. But hidden. It was hidden in God. And again, predestined before the ages. Here we can yet again see the wisdom of God working to keep his plan hidden, to keep it safe from the enemy, if you will. The plan was hidden, but with the death of Jesus, the plan was revealed to us. It's in the Holy Word here. If you'll turn with me to Ephesians 3:9-10, I'll go back. Ephesians 3:9-10 states, "And to bring to light what is the administration of the mystery, which for ages has been hidden in God who created all things, in order that the manifold wisdom of God might now be made known through the church to the rulers and the authorities in the heavenly places." It talks about bringing to light the mystery that has been hidden in God, by God, and it talks here about revealing this mystery and letting it be known to the fellowship, the administration. And I just think, that it's interesting how he hid it, and then how we can see it revealed, and we'll see that in this next verse, which is 1 Corinthians 2:10. "For to us God revealed them through the Spirit, for the Spirit searches all things, even the depths of God." It is revealed through the Spirit. It is revealed to us through the Spirit. And from God to us through the Spirit. And so We see the wisdom of God throughout all of these texts here that were listed for this point, and just how he revealed it. It was, I thought throughout this week as studying it, that it's been a really interesting, what he did, how he hid it, how he revealed it, and that he has a plan, that he has always had a plan. And I never had really thought about that he had a plan. I mean, it never really crossed my mind, but it's listed very clearly in these texts. But God's plan won't work if we don't evangelize. And I love to teach about, or not teach, but talk about evangelism and study on it, but I was only given a week and also a 15-minute period to work with. So I unfortunately will not be able to do that. But through the power of God's wisdom and his plan for the church, you can be saved from all, or we can be saved from all of our sins. I hope that through the information that I have presented to you all this morning, that God has a, that you all understand and remember that God has a plan for the church. And again, I had never thought about that. It never crossed my mind. And I don't know if it's that way for everyone, but it certainly was that way for me. He always has had that plan, and that he hid it for the sakes of our salvation, that he has revealed the plan through Christ. That's all I've got. Thank you. Yeah.